where Miami is like the only pool in the world where you have the pool right there in the middle, then all the way around you have people just on sunbathers, just chilling out, getting their sun, students in between the lessons, just straight chilling. What a beautiful place this is.
What's happening here? Jonas shows up, man. And the girls just come. Jonas shows up and all the girls show around, man.
Alright guys, I'm back here in Leeds finally after my trip to Miami. Crompton, come say hi mate. You might as well, since you're here.
You're right, boys.
Back with Crompton as well.
I've got an injury, I can't get in.
Oh man.
I know, it
That's
sucks.
So sad.
It sucks.
I hate injuries. Injuries really suck.
When's this video going up?
This video? Yeah. I don't actually know. I was actually hoping to post it today, but I've not finished it. Probably either Thursday or Friday.
We have YouTube videos coming on Crompton soon, boys. Soon, I
He's
promise.
He's coming back soon. Anyway, I just wanted to speak to a little bit about my bogey dive, my reverse 3.5, which is one that I kind of like have dropped so many times in my career, but it's slowly getting there. I first did this dive in 2012. I learned it kind of as just a bit of a laugh at nationals after all the competitions finished. Me and my coach just decided that it was time to give it a blast on 3 meter. So I went up and this is how it went. So I kind of worked on it a little bit, not much, in the 2 years following that. But I started to do it more in 2014. I started to do it reasonably well occasionally. Like I'd do a few bad ones that I struggled, but then I'd do a few really good ones. And then I got to the Commonwealth Games and we got into the final and I was like, should we throw it in? Because I've been training it and my coach agreed, so we threw it into the list. I did a really good one in training, but it literally ruined my entire competition at the Commonwealth Games because I was running like third or fourth place up until this dive. And I did it, dropped it, and ended up in 11th overall. So hopefully this time round, I'll be able to redeem myself and do the reverse 3.5 slightly better. Since then, I kind of used it at various competitions, including nationals, a couple of Grand Prix as well in 2015 in Puerto Rico, also in Canada. I did it reasonably well in Puerto Rico, struggled in Canada though, but then got to the Pan American Games. I literally did my best one ever then, okay, at the time. Do you want to come see my best ever reverse 3.5? Okay. What? Okay.
Was that talking?
Some Korean coach.
Oh, you're not.
So I did that in training. I was literally buzzing because that was the best time I've ever done it. Then competition came around. I was struggling a bit more, but I got to the World Championships in that same year and did it and literally landed on my back and got threes. I didn't even film it. Didn't even get it filmed because it was that bad. I've forgotten all about it. So after that World Championships, I decided to leave it and go back to my reverse 2.5 pipe, which was slightly easier. And I was much more confident with, so that when it came to the Olympics and the qualification for the Olympics, I'd have something that I knew I could nail. It worked an absolute treat. I did one of my best ever reverse 3.5 pipes in the semi-final on my way to actually winning a silver medal at the World Cup. Alright guys, so listen, this is my session today, right? I'm doing 3 optionals.
Okay.
Yeah. I think I've been decided by this guy.
Nice. I like that.
Have you ever played this game before?
No, but I like
it's what AD used to play back in the day. So, we take this dice, I'm going to roll it. Alright. So this is my first optional.
Okay.
It's like, orders, so like, yeah.
One. Come on.
Okay, second one.
Five.
That's full out.
Dude, that's like an easy freaking list, man.
Last one. Nah, I can't do that again. Four.
All right.
In one. Oh no, yeah, no, it's a gainers because I do it in my list. I do it in my list order. I do it in my list order, so my order goes forward, back, reverse. Forward, back, inward, reverse. So dive number four is reverse. So then my three dives. I got to the Olympic Games myself and did it pretty well. It got me through to the semi-final and I also did a decent win in the semi. It's just a shame I dropped a couple of other dives. But then since 2016 I've been working to get this dive back in my list because the DD is so high compared to a resting off pike. It's almost a necessity now in men's diving, so it's something I've been really working really hard on, and it's been up and down. I did a couple of decent ones in Madrid and in Edinburgh last year in 2017. Hey! Finally this season it's actually started to pick up a bit of steam. I did a really really good one in Australia following a really disastrous one in the prelim, but then I dropped it in the final as well. I kind of struggled at the start of 2018 to get it right. That was due to, you know, a small injury in my shoulder, but I still pushed hard on it because it's still possible, and my old coach Edwin believes that I can get up to 85 points in this dive. Obviously I went out to Miami recently, I was smashing it out there doing some good ones and doing some really bad ones, but my best one ever came in this training session in Miami. The reason why it's my best one ever, even though it wasn't in competition, the reason why is because I did five of them beforehand which really really struggled, and I was working to make the right change like my coach was saying out there. I just kept going short and short and short and short. I never gave up. I kept trying it. Finally, my last one, my coach put a little bit of pressure on me to get it down, saying this is my last one, this is my last chance to get it good. I made the right changes, got the right start, probably got one of my best ends ever that I've caught on camera anyway on this dive right here. So that is my best ever reverse 3.5, and it's perfect timing because we're coming up to Commonwealth Games and this dive is going to be a major, major key for my performance. Hopefully it goes well, we'll see, but I'm going to keep on working hard, keep on trying to get it right. As usual, the hustle never stops with this dive or with anything that I'm doing. Let's keep up this momentum and let's keep going. See you soon. Peace out.